Vandaag geen True Tuesdays, maar een bijzondere aflevering van Hart in Actie. En ik speel Natasja Vroger, maar dan kaal en grijzend. Waarom gaan we vandaag iemand helpen? Dat komt omdat deze jongen op zijn weblog een noodkreet had geplaatst. Hij vroeg, moet ik wel gaan studeren? Normaal niet zo heel bijzonder, maar voor deze jongen wel. Hij heeft namelijk al 2 jaar vanaf zijn 15e een florerend bedrijf, Teens in Tech. En hij schrijft voor een van de beroemdste weblogs ter wereld over technologie, TechCrunch. Thanks for taking the time out of your busy schedule to meet with us.
Thanks for having me.
And we're very concerned. You know, we came over here because you're 17 years old. Mm-hmm. You're the CEO of a company called Teens in Tech. You write for one of the world's biggest tech blogs, TechCrunch. And you're also consulting still for a company called Quick.
So I'm actually, I started out as a consultant, but now I'm part-time. So I've been with the company for 2 years this month.
Which company?
Quick.
Quick.
Yeah. And you know, Teens in Tech, we're coming up on our 2-year anniversary next month. So it was a matter of a month between me starting Teens in Tech and me joining Quick. So
yeah, and then you write for TechCrunch?
And I write for TechCrunch. I've been at TechCrunch since June. And
My problem is that, you know, isn't this the time when you should be out there binge drinking and getting in all kinds of trouble? Just the things that regular 17-year-old teenagers do.
Every weekend I hang out with my friends, you know, I still go to school. I mean, I live pretty much a normal teenager life from, you know, 8 to
2
to like 1 o'clock when I'm at school. After that, that's when my fun starts.
That's kind of a short school day.
So, I mean, I'm a senior this year, so I've taken all my required classes, so I just take the bare minimum. So I can just get out.
You take the bare minimum?
Yeah. So I start class at 8 o'clock and I end at 12:40 every day.
Yeah, because I only came here and flew around the world because I was very concerned about your blog post asking people, should I go to college or not?
Yes, that and was I quite thought, the... That got a lot of traffic. I was
email
very
was
surprised.
Too easy after we flew in. We
yeah.
said, we gotta rescue this kid.
Yeah. But I mean, what I've decided is I'm gonna try it for a year. I'm gonna see if college is a good fit for me. I mean, I'm not a fan of school, and I've made this very public that I do not want to spend my time in a classroom not learning what I want to learn. What I want to learn is in where we are right now in Silicon Valley. I want to meet people. I want to build my business. I want to learn how to write. You know, I'm a writer at TechCrunch. I mean, all of these different things is, you know, it's learning, and I'm not getting that learning from school. So that's one of my main reasons on why I actually don't like school.
No, I understand, but isn't there like an education out here that you can do those kind of things but still stay in school?
I mean, the only way that I could see it is being homeschooled. And then I wouldn't see my friends and all of that.
Yeah.
Which is a problem. And, you know, I've considered going to college early. Our high school has a program where your senior year, your 12th year of school, you can go and take classes at your local community college. And, I mean, then I still wouldn't see my friends.
Yeah.
I mean... It was a very hard decision.
Oh, that's why we're here. We're here to help.
Yeah, exactly. So, I mean, it's like therapy right now.
It's counseling, young
counseling, man. Counseling. So, you know, it's, yeah, we're going to see how it goes for a year. Haven't decided where I'm going to go yet. I've put in applications for numerous colleges and just waiting to hear back.
I love the fact that that they will get your application, knowing that you didn't really want to go.
Exactly. And I think my grades will show it.
Really? Your grades are not
I mean, I have normal grades. I just don't try. I mean, I gave up. You know.
You're like the unmotivated kid in the back of the class shooting paper.
No, I'm on my iPhone doing emails.
They allow you to do that in class?
No. I still do it, though.
You know, can you...
Yeah, under my desk, writing emails.
Really?
Yeah.
That's annoying.
I gotta run a business.
You gotta run a... Why?
Why? Because this is what I love to do. I wouldn't be spending so much time and staying up until 3 or 4 in the morning the night before a big launch. You know.
See, I'm not worried about you not going to school. I'm worried about you not having enough parties.
Oh, I go to plenty of parties.
Having fun, because I think you can work your whole life. You know, probably you're gonna be like 89 years old, you know, so maybe 100. Life expectancy is increasing, as you surely know.
Yeah.
So you can work, you know, your whole life. Why do you want to work now when you started at 15?
I don't consider it work. I consider it fun. This is my play. This is, you know, a lot of my peers, they go and play sports. This is my sport. Technology is what I want to do after school. I mean, I've been doing this for 4 years now, ever since middle school. You know, when I first got my first job doing IT. I mean,
how do you get a job at when you're 13?
So, interesting story. So my dad worked at this company called Remend, and they did bank software to help you, like help banks when mm-hmm. house goes under foreclosure. And so they help make
software.
He
must have been really busy the last couple of years.
And so at the job, I learned HTML, CSS, JavaScript, like front-end code. And I also learned a lot about like managing servers, MySQL, databases, and stuff like that.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah, so if anything, that job taught me the most out of anything. Because without that job, it was like my starting block. And from there, I could, you know, after that, I joined Quick. And then at Quick, that's when I really got into marketing. When I was working at Remend, I heard of a guy named Leo Laporte and Robert Scoble.
Yeah.
Podcaster and a blogger.
Yeah.
And I was like, well, I think I should do that too. So I started my own blog on WordPress, and yeah. I started my own podcast about Apple, because I'm a huge Apple fanboy. I mean, you saw my desk. I have a 30-inch Apple monitor, you know, it's MacBook Pro, iPhone.
You're spoiled.
I'm addicted. It's an issue. That's the way my parents see
Again,
it.
And that's why I'm here.
Yeah, exactly. We're venting. Yeah. And so I started this podcast called the Apple Universe Podcast, which was all about Macs, Apple.
Yeah, which is how I got to know you, actually.
Yeah. You know, I got to know a lot of that community, the podcaster and blogger community. So Quick brought me on to help me be the middleman between the product and the community. So in a way, I was like a community manager. A couple of weeks ago, I actually stepped down from the podcast, and I've just taken...
You retired.
I retired. I mean, there's a new host and producer who's bringing the show back later this year, and, you know, it was a fun ride. It was 3 years, and, you know, Apple invited me to all their press events and stuff like that.
Yeah, would you have all this information about what was going on with Apple?
Exactly.
New software releases?
Exactly, and so now that I'm at TechCrunch, this is like the mecca of online media and journalism. And, you know, it just got to a point where I just couldn't do so many things without having that personal life that you were talking about. So I decided to scale back a little bit. I was consulting for a company called Apture, and I took a leave of absence from them and stopped producing and hosting the Apple Universe podcast and just focused on the three main things that I really enjoyed, which was Quick, Teens in Tech, and TechCrunch.
Okay, so tell me about Teens in Tech. What do you do there?
What do I do there? It's what do I don't do is the actual question. So I'm the CEO.
Founder,
CEO.
Chairman
of the board, president.
Majority shareholder.
Yeah. We actually have a couple of shareholders. We have some investors.
You do still have the majority?
Oh, of course.
And you got all the preferences?
Oh, yeah.
So you learned about term sheets?
Oh, yeah. I mean, part of the thing about Silicon Valley is you meet a lot with lawyers. I mean, our law firm is amazing, and
Who are you with?
Gunderson Dettmer. Mm. So they're in Redwood City, and they're an amazing law firm. So, you know, they really, you know, being that I'm a young age, they have to protect me.
Can you sign for your own contract?
My parents co-sign for everything, so except for working contracts, I think. So when
you can sign yourself, but you cannot sign into any legally binding contracts.
Exactly. So my parents co-sign for everything. And so, I mean, Teens in Tech is a big company. We have 18 employees. We're completely virtual, and we have 5 products. And I see all these companies like with this BS marketing language, just trying to get users, and it's just amusing. It's kind of like designers look at websites, and they're like critiquing it. I critique, you know, what these
youth marketing.
Exactly.
How companies try to talk to young people. You
know? Exactly, and it's funny because they think, oh, you know, we have a Facebook group, join it, and you know, you'll have so much fun there. But you have to look at me as a very, like an exceptional teenager to the group of teenagers. Because I'm not your average, you know, teenager. I actually, you know, I'm into Twitter, into Facebook, into Web 2.0, consumer applications. And
you're more like a 27-year-old than a 17-year-old.
Exactly.
In terms of media use.
Exactly. So, I mean, I love email. I'm addicted to email, to Twitter.
And kids don't use email anymore.
I mean, it's not that they don't use it. They use it for their Facebook messages, notifications.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, Facebook is the new email for them because they have an inbox there.
Yeah. And they don't use Twitter?
They don't use Twitter.
Why?
They have no need to. I mean, Facebook gives them already enough sharing functionality that Twitter is like, well, I have Facebook.
And in Europe, all the kids, all the teens use MSN Messenger.
Is that like still we use here? AIM here.
Use AIM, yeah.
Yeah. For me, I mean, I use Skype because of the video and audio chatting capabilities.
That's with your colleagues especially, right?
Exactly. Especially all over the world, we need to be able to do conference calls.
Yeah.
I use AIM for my friends and for other colleagues. And then Jabber, so GTalk, for TechCrunch, we use Jabber for internal.
Yeah.
We also use Yammer. And at Teens in Tech, we use SocialCast. I mean, there's all these different technologies that just help collaboration and communication. Mm. And for companies like Teens in Tech, it's just... these are the best because when we're virtual and global.
And they're cheap.
And they're free.
Yeah.
Yammer is free. SocialCast is free. I mean, these great applications are free. And that's just what makes these consumer applications great.
And is it something that big companies follow really closely? Because I'm assuming that they're all following you like hawks. Like, what's going on? These guys have the secret sauce for talking
to people. It's a good thing and it's a bad thing. The good thing is that you have huge companies wanting to talk to you. Mm-hmm. So I'm giving a talk at SAP in a couple of weeks because they want to know what's hot right now.
The Germans.
And
you want to tell them what's going on with the young kids?
Yeah. And then also, I mean...
That's interesting. Why would SAP care? That's interesting.
Because they have an innovations department where they want to figure out what's hot right now and how to use SAP products around that and how to build them.
Do you have an idea what you're going to say?
I mean, they want to know what's hot right now. And of course, I'm going to talk about...
Okay, you can tell them that.
Yeah.
But you can't tell them what they're going to do with enterprise software and marketing young kids.
I don't know enterprise. I mean, I use enterprise applications.
You're not missing much.
Yeah, exactly.
Trust me.
Enterprise is boring.
I've been there. It's woo. Ask mom.
Yeah, exactly.
She'll tell you. Yep. And what's up next?
I'm going to go to the gym tonight. So, got to stay in shape.
What do you do at the gym?
I work out. I mean,
on your iPhone?
Yeah.
Do you put it away? Do you actually spend time without it?
It's very hard to. Even an hour without this is hard. Like, the first thing I do when I get this is I check Twitter, I check Facebook.
Young man, that's what you should say about a girlfriend. Or a girl. It doesn't have to be a girlfriend. An hour without her would be difficult.
Yes.
I'm not saying an hour without my iPhone.
I mean, it's
I'm still
hard.
Concerned. It's not gone yet.
It all depends. I mean, so tomorrow I'm probably going to go to Quick.
So you mix the hours with Quick, with TechCrunch, and Teens in Tech you do from here.
Teens in Tech I can do from anywhere.
From anywhere, exactly.
As long as I have a computer and an internet connection, I'm running my company.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So how many hours do you think you work a week? Any ID? You make 40 hours, it almost seems like. Like a full work week.
A full work week plus more, I would say.
Plus school.
I mean, but I also work a lot on the weekends.
True, of course.
Yeah. So
you do the weekends with it. Oh my God, yeah, you're doing a work week plus.
But I mean, I don't consider it work. I mean, this is fun for me.
You consider school to be the...
I consider it boring.
Cumbersome and boring.
Yeah, a lot of people go into their jobs and they hate it because they think it's boring. And Gary Vaynerchuk keeps saying that if you hate what you're doing, then stop doing it and find something that you want
to
do.
I think he's talking to adults, though, when he says that.
I mean, this can go for anyone, though.
Yeah, but what is
it's
your
sister? It's the mindset.
Do you have a little brother or sister?
I have an older sister. She's much older.
Okay, let's say you have a little brother that's 6 years old and says, well, I don't feel like going to school.
There's a fine line between, you know...
But where's the line?
Only you can tell where it is. I mean, for me, my line was crossed 3 years ago when I gave up. When I gave up on school.
What did your teacher say? Do they think you're the irritating kid in class that knows everything better? Or the
no,
kid?
The thing is...
The stoner in the back. What do they think?
My teachers are extremely supportive.
Oh, that's cool. That's
so
nice.
My principal is probably the most supportive.
Maybe he doesn't like coming to school either.
I mean, with her, the big thing is that she understands technology. She understands that we kids are in the 21st century. My old principal didn't understand that. So this is her second year in being the principal.
The new principal.
And so she just understands it. And that's what makes this so easy is that I can go for 5 days to CES in Vegas and not have any problems at school and not have to worry about that.
Because
I know that, you know, my principal is going to be behind me because she knows that this is probably more important to me than what I actually do in school. And we've had numerous meetings with my parents, with the counselors,
with everyone. You're like the troubled kid.
You know? I am the troubled kid, but the thing is, like, a lot of the actually troubled kids have to do with, like, they'll smoke weed or they'll drink and stuff like that. For me, it's, I love technology.
And you're off the crystal meth now.
It's actually, there's this drug that a lot of startups use to stay awake for 40, 50 hours.
Which one is that?
It's made by Cellophon. We actually wrote about this a couple of years ago because we knew a lot of startup CEOs and...
Are we using drugs to stay awake?
Yeah, because they had to get code done and stuff like that. So, I mean, it's sad, but I mean, these are what they're doing.
And that's legal? Or?
Yeah, it's a legal drug over the counter.
You Americans, funny people.
Yeah.
Any huge trends that we should follow that you think that are coming up?
I mean...
What do you think we're missing?
Online video, I think, is going to be very big, especially mobile video. Just keep an eye out on mobile and online video.
So we'll follow mobile video.
Yeah.
And we'll follow
online video, the mobile devices. Yeah, it's all going to be huge.
Okay, we'll be following you. Thanks for your time.
Thank you very much.
Enjoy college.
I will, definitely.
Enjoy being an entrepreneur.
Thank you.
Have fun.
Thank you. I don't think half the people that read TechCrunch know that I'm 17.
I actually didn't either.
Yeah?
Until I didn't even know in the podcast. Me. I didn't know in the... I was.
How could you not tell? My voice was like a girl's.
Well, because a lot of Americans have weird voices, you know, to me.